Okay, Roger. So today, 2-0, right? And you came down to the wire against Oklahoma. You win at heavyweight, right? What, 18-16? Is that what the duel ended up?
It ended up 21-16.
21-16. Yeah. Okay, so you got to win heavyweight.
Yep.
Right. You come out. You get a third period takedown on the edge of the mat. Right, you're wrestling hard in all positions. What do you think the difference was today between, obviously you rolled on Kent State, but what was the difference in Oklahoma duel?
You know, it's just about being gritty the whole time and keep wrestling, putting points on the board. That's all we keep talking to our guys about. If you just focus on putting points on the board, good things are going to happen. And, you know, we're focusing on more of the positive instead of what's going wrong. And, you know, when you focus on the positive, good things are naturally going to happen.
Griffin, let's just talk about this guy. I like depth.
Yeah.
Holy smokes. Yep. He hammered two guys today.
Yep.
Right? He hammered a three-time Ohio State champion, right, against Oklahoma. Major decision for you, right? It's a huge part of the match.
Yep.
Penn, the Kent State guy. He's your quote-unquote backup, would you say, right?
Yep.
Right? Where's Rayvon right now?
Rayvon, he's still recovering from his knee surgery he had in June after the World Team Trials. I mean, he's wrestling right now, but we're just kind of working him through his, you know, recovery.
Building depth like that. Griffin's a guy who he qualified for the NCAA tournament. I don't think there's any doubt. He's pretty good, right?
You know, Logan's a, you know, he's a journeyman, you know? I mean, he's been a program guy. And, you know, we talked about at the beginning of the year, we went on a, you know, what we call a team building trip. And, you know, guys talked about goals and everything. And Logan came in with a pretty big class, and he's the only one remaining from it. And he's the only fifth-year senior. He started out as a freshman. He made it all the way through. And it says a lot about him as a person. And there's no doubt, you know, Rayvon Foley being there has made him better. And I think he's made Rayvon Foley better. And when you have that situation happening, good things are going to happen naturally.
So, he's a huge part of the two wins today. I mean,
yep, that was a team win.
Right?
That was a team win.
You look at 174, you know, that's tough. You lost a team point, by the way.
I know.
Which I don't disagree with. Like, you're fighting for the danger call.
Yeah.
That's why we need two officials, right? Because the danger was there, and but 174, that's another guy. You know, he's right there. He loses two tough matches today against two quality opponents. You're right there to pop off with 6-7 qualifiers, right? What do you got to do to get in that 6-7-8 qualifier?
The Spartans are coming. These guys have self-belief, and you know what? They've made me a believer because of the work they've put in. And I'm telling you, up and down the line, we have a good program right now. And the depth is great, and we're still relatively young. You know, most of our team is juniors and younger. And you know, I'm just excited to be a part of their journey, and you know, I'm excited that they're taking me along for the ride.
Caffey's an absolute horse, just a mutant, man. Did you see the two pins he had today?
Yeah.
They were just like pure horsepower pins against, once again, two guys who are pretty good.
Yeah.
Right? I think that's a guy. He's a threat, man. I'm not saying, like, top eight threat. I'm saying, like, look out for this guy. You know, like, Zahid Valencia, if he wrestles that guy, you're going to have to wrestle him hard, right? You got a guy like that who can, you know, have Rayvon. You got another guy. He's a threat. You got two guys who could make the national finals. Would that surprise you at all if those guys went and got the job done?
I see how these guys work. You know, I see them every day. I know their mindset. I know what they want to accomplish. They talk about it. And so, yeah, they're two of the many special kids in our program. And I think you're going to start seeing a lot more here over the, you know, upcoming months and upcoming years. And, you know, there's no doubt that Rayvon and Cam's kind of set a standard for our program last year. And, you know, young guys can be successful early. You don't have to wait until you're a junior or senior. And that's kind of the mindset. Let's do this now.
Santos. Santos goes into overtime with the number two guy in the country, right?
Yeah.
I think that's the grit we're talking about.
Yeah.
I think that's like the Spartans are coming,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
He's right there.
Yeah.
And you know, like, talking, maybe if he wants that match a little bit more, he picks up a win against Dom Demas. Instead, he gets ducked in overtime.
Yep.
What's he got to do to get that win? And what do you guys, like, there's some weights where it's a toss-up yet.
Yep.
41, 33, you listed two guys, right?
Yep.
So you know, there's still questions to be answered about the Spartans, right? What do you got to do to get a decision there and get the guys, pick the 33 and pick the 41 potter?
You know, I mean, we got some tournaments. Our next two events, we don't have duels until the South Beach duels. Our next duel meets aren't until the South Beach duel. So we have two tournaments coming up, and we're going to kind of let it play out and see what happens there. And, you know, I don't want to handpick anybody. I want them to decide it on the mat. So, but there's no doubt. Matt Santos, you know, he's been a student of the sport, and I think his biggest thing was believing in himself, and he's got that belief right now and confidence, and you know that came from his training all summer and through the fall, and you know when you do good things happen.
Okay, I saw a legend here today, a Michigan State legend, an NCAA champion, Northeast Ohio legend, a family. I saw Tom Milkovich. He's NCAA champ for you. Last team before Penn State to win in 2011 was the Spartans in the 60s. Did you know that? Last team east of the Mississippi. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Yeah, they were the last team to win, and then Penn State won. No team had done that. You guys were the last one.
Okay.
Right? The seeds are right there. Did you get to talk to him today at all?
Yeah, you know, Tom is – he just got inducted into our Michigan State Athletics Hall of Fame, you know, a few weeks back. And I've got to spend quite a bit of time with him. And, you know, even though I've known Tom for quite some time, I really got to know him. We spent a lot of time talking. And you know what? His knowledge, his wisdom is second to none, you know. And he knows what he's talking about. He came in and talked to our team the weekend that we had our green and white meet in Russ-Loss. I want our alumni to come back and talk about the history and talk about what our guys need to do to get that mindset right to, you know, be All-Americans and national champs.
I think people forget you guys have been NCAA champs before.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
It could get done again. It's Sparty. I don't ever put anything past your athletic department, right? Like, look at your basketball team.
Yeah.
Look at your football team. Your competitors every year. So I don't put anything past Sparty. And then, you know, Helen, the head field hockey coach, you know, I was the best man at her wedding, if you didn't know that.
I did know that.
Good people, though. But, you know what I mean? Like, your athletic department, it's there. Yep. It's right there. You got anything else for me?
No. I appreciate everything you do to promote the sport. And, you know what? We're excited to start out the year 2-0, and I know these guys are coming.
All right. Give me a quick Guy Seiko shout-out. I gave the coaches some soap, okay? He's a St. Ed guy. You're a St. Ed guy. Goss is a St. Ed guy.
Yep.
You guys use defense soap, right?
Yep.
You guys don't play.
We don't
keep guys on the mat.
Defense soap, it's the way to go, man. Keep your guys on the mat, not off the mat.
I got you guys some wipes, too.
Awesome.
Tell your guys to get cleaned up, all right? Get them washed up. I got to talk to Kathy here. Coach, thanks for the time. Go Sparty.